السلام عليكم. I will start by the developmental periods. We have two periods, prenatal periods and they are three, and the postnatal periods and they are six. Prenatal periods are pre-embryonic period, embryonic period, and fetal period. Pre-embryonic period again, pre-embryonic period, then formation of the embryo, then formation of the fetus. Postnatal periods start by the newborn or neonatal period, then infancy or infant, then a child, then puberty, and then adolescent or adolescence, 3 to 4 years after puberty, and then adult. Again, the prenatal periods are three periods: pre-embryonic period, embryonic period, and fetal period. The pre-embryonic period is the first 3 weeks. The embryonic period from week 4 to week 9, the fetal period from week 9 till birth. The pre-embryonic period, first 3 weeks, the first week is fertilization and blastocyst formation. Second week is the formation of the bilaminar plate or two germ layers. Remember, second week, two germ layers. 3 weeks, third week, three germ layers. Then the embryonic period, formation of the embryo, characterized by two events, two major events. Formation of the organs, it's called organogenesis. Formation of the shape, morphogenesis. Then the fetal period, from week 9 till birth. During this period, there is no new formation of any organ, but maturation of the organs and growth of the fetus in length and in weight. Then we'll talk about the changes in the second week of development. Second week is the week of twos. Number one, implantation of the blastocyst begins on day 6 and completed on day 11. After implantation, the blastocyst, the endometrium is called decidua. Then formation of two layers of the trophoblast, formation of two layers of two germ layers of the inner cell mass, epiblast and hypoblast, formation of two cavities, amniotic cavity and yolk cavity, formation of extra embryonic mesoderm and its two layers, somatic and splenic or parietal and visceral. Okay, this is a very important topic. Sites of implantation. Sites of implantation, we have two major sites, normal and abnormal. The normal site is in the upper part of the posterior wall of the body of the uterus in the midline. The abnormal sites may be uterine or extrauterine. The uterine in the lower part of the uterus, and it is called the placenta previa. The extrauterine sites are called ectopic sites, and the commonest site of ectopic pregnancy is the uterine tube, tubal pregnancy, then ovarian pregnancy, and abdominal pregnancy. Placenta previa. This is the normal site of the placenta in the upper part of the posterior wall of the body of the uterus. This is placenta previa. Placenta is formed in the lower part of the uterus near the internal os. So placenta previa is implantation of the blastocyst in the lower part of the uterus near the internal os. We have three types. First one, this one, placenta previa lateralis. The placenta in the lower part of the uterus, but doesn't reach the internal os. Placenta previa marginalis in the lower part of the uterus and partially covers the internal os. Placenta previa centralis completely covers the internal os, and it is very dangerous because premature separation of the placenta might cause severe bleeding. Then ectopic pregnancy. What is ectopic pregnancy? Is pregnancy outside the uterus. And the commonest site is tubal pregnancy in the uterine tube. And the fate of the tubal pregnancy is tubal rupture and internal hemorrhage. Second one, ovarian pregnancy. Implantation of the blastocyst on the surface of the ovary, and it is rare. And then abdominal pregnancy, implantation of the blastocyst and the formation of the embryo on the surface of the intestine or the stomach. Abdominal pregnancy, and it is also rare. After implantation, the endometrium is called decidua. So what is decidua? Decidua is the endometrium of the uterus after implantation. We have three types, and you should know the fate of each type. We have decidua basalis, between the blastocyst and the myometrium, blastocyst and the myometrium. Decidua capsularis, between the blastocyst and the uterine cavity. Decidua parietalis, it is the remaining part of the decidua. The decidua basalis is the most important one because it forms the maternal part of the placenta. Maternal part of the placenta. Decidua capsularis and parietalis degenerate. Now we go to the changes during the second week. Or changes in the blastocyst. You know that the blastocyst is formed of inner cell mass and outer cell mass. Inner cell mass is called embryoblast because it forms the embryo. Outer cell mass is called the trophoblast and it forms the placenta. So we have changes in the inner cell mass and the changes in the trophoblast. Changes in the trophoblast, four major changes. Number one, differentiation of the trophoblast into two layers, the light green and the dark green, cytotrophoblast and the syncytial trophoblast. Syncytial trophoblast erodes the endometrium and erodes the capillaries forming the cavities. These cavities become filled with blood, with maternal blood, blood from the mother, formation of cavities or lacunae filled with blood. These cavities become continuous with the maternal capillaries or maternal sinusoids, establishing the utero-placental circulation. And then formation of chorionic villi, primary chorionic villi, to fix the blastocyst into the endometrium. Again, it changes in the trophoblast. This is the trophoblast. This is the inner cell mass. So the first change in the trophoblast, formation of two layers. Syncytial trophoblast and the cytotrophoblast. Appearance of cavities or lacunae filled with blood, maternal blood. These cavities become continuous with the maternal capillaries. Establishment of the uteroplacental circulation. And then formation of the primary chorionic villi. Extensions from the cytotrophoblast into the syncytial trophoblast. Fixing the blastocyst into the endometrium. Now changes in the inner cell mass. which will form the embryo. First exchange, the inner cell mass, this one, becomes divided into two layers. Epiblast, the blue one, hypoblast, the yellow one. Formation of cavity inside the epiblast, this one, the amniotic cavity. Formation of this membrane, the yellow membrane from the hypoblast, exocelomic membrane. This exocelomic membrane surrounds a new cavity called primary yolk sac cavity, this one. The exocelomic membrane forms a new tissue between the trophoblast and the exocelomic membrane. This new tissue is called extraembryonic mesoderm. Cavity appear in the intraembryonic mesoderm, it's called extraembryonic coelom, and then formation of the chorion. This is the inner cell mass, becomes divided into two layers, epiblast and hypoblast. Appearance of cavity in the epiblast, this one, amniotic cavity. Formation of exocelomic membrane, this one, which surrounds a new cavity called primary yolk sac cavity. The exocelomic membrane, this one, forms a new tissue, extraembryonic mesoderm. Cavities appear in the extraembryonic mesoderm, which will form the extraembryonic coelom, extraembryonic cavity. This coelom divides the extraembryonic mesoderm into visceral layer and the parietal layer, or somatic layer, this one, and the splenic layer, this one. This is again, this is epiblast, hypoblast, amniotic cavity, yolk sac cavity. This is extraembryonic mesoderm, okay, and this is the connecting stalk, the future umbilical cord. The chorion is formed of three layers: syncytic trophoblast, cytotrophoblast, extraembryonic somatic mesoderm. So the chorion is formed of three layers, and I can say that the chorion is formed of two layers. Number one and two are the trophoblast, and number three is extraembryonic mesoderm. So trophoblast and extraembryonic somatic mesoderm. Summary: it changes in the trophoblast and it changes in the inner cell mass. It changes in the trophoblast are four: differentiation into two layers, cytotrophoblast and syncytic trophoblast. Appearance of cavities or lacunae filled with maternal blood. Establishment of uteroplacental circulation. Formation of primary chorionic villi. It changes in the inner cell mass. The inner cell mass becomes divided into two layers, epiblast and hypoblast. Formation of cavity inside the epiblast, the amniotic cavity. Formation of exocelomic membrane from the hypoblast. This membrane surrounds a new cavity, the yolk sac cavity. Formation of tissue, extraembryonic mesoderm, from the exocelomic membrane. Cavity appear in the extraembryonic mesoderm, extraembryonic coelom, divides the mesoderm into somatic layer and the splenic layer. Formation of secondary yolk sac, and the formation of the chorion. Now, summary of the changes in the trophoblast. Two layers of trophoblast, cyto and syncytio trophoblast. Two germ layers, epiblast and hypoblast, forming bilaminar germ disk. Formation of two cavities, amniotic cavity and yolk sac cavity. Formation of two layers of extraembryonic mesoderm, somatic and splenic. third week. In the third week, the bilaminar plate becomes trilaminar. Or we can say the trilaminar plate is formed during the third week. The process is formation of the trilaminar plate is called the gastrulation. So what is gastrulation? Simply, gastrulation is the formation of the trilaminar plate. We have several changes in the bilaminar plate. Again, this is the bilaminar plate, epiblast and hypoblast. Okay, number one, formation of this plate, precordal plate. Formation of this line, primitive streak. Formation of this node, primitive node. Formation of this cord, notochord. Formation of the three germ layers, ectoderm, endoderm, and mesoderm, and the formation of allantois. Start by the precordal plate. Again, we'll draw the two germ layers. The bilaminar plate. This is the epiblast. This is the hypoblast. The cranial end of the hypoblast become columnar, or the cuboidal hypoblast cells become columnar. This precordal plate fuses with the epiblast to form a membrane called the buccopharyngeal membrane. Buccopharyngeal membrane is a future oral cavity. This precordal plate prevents forward growth of the developing notochord. Then the primitive streak. This is the epiblast. This is the hypoblast. This is the precordal plate. This is the notochord. This is the buccopharyngeal membrane. The primitive streak is proliferation of the caudal part of the epiblast in the midline. It appears as a dark line, actually. The epiblast and the hypoblast caudal to the primitive streak fuse to form another membrane, which is the cloacal membrane. This cloacal membrane is a future site of the inner canal. This primitive streak is the main source of intra-embryonic mesoderm. So the primitive streak is formed from epiblast. Therefore, the intra-embryonic mesoderm is formed from epiblast. Then the primitive node. Again, this is the epiblast. This is the hypoblast. This is the precordal plate. This is the buccopharyngeal membrane. This is the cloacal membrane. This is the primitive streak. Primitive node is another area of proliferation at the cranial end of the primitive streak. Yes. From the primitive node, a cord of cells extend between the epiblast and the hypoblast. This cord of cells is called notochord. And it takes part in the formation of the interembryonic mesoderm. This is the buccopharyngeal membrane. Buccopharyngeal membrane. This is the cloacal membrane. This is the cloacal membrane. This is the primitive streak. This is the primitive node. This is the primitive streak. Yes. This is the primitive node. And this is the notochord. This is the amniotic cavity, yoxic cavity, epiblast, hypoblast. Then the notochord. Again, this is the epiblast, hypoblast, precordal plate, buccopharyngeal membrane, cloacal membrane, primitive streak, primitive node. This is the ectoderm. Sorry, this is the epiblast. This is the hypoblast. The notochord is formed from the primitive node. It extends forward between the epiblast and the hypoblast. Okay? Notochord between epiblast and hypoblast. The notochord has two main functions. Number one, it forms the midline axis around which the vertebral column is formed. Number two, it induces the development of the central nervous system, brain and the spinal cord. After the formation of the vertebral column, the notochord degenerates except two parts. The upper part will form a part of the skull, and the remaining part will form nucleus pulposus of the intervertebral disc. This is the intervertebral disc. This is the intervertebral disc, and the central part of the intervertebral disc is the nucleus pulposus. The formation of the three germ layers, ectoderm, endoderm, and mesoderm. This is the epiblast. Some cells migrate to replace the hypoblast and form endoderm, and then the hypoblast disappear. So the endoderm is derived from the epiblast. Another cells, the red ones, migrate between the epiblast and the formed endoderm to form the mesoderm. Again, then the mesoderm is derived from epiblast. The remaining cells form the ectoderm. Therefore, the three germ layers are formed from epiblast. What are the three germ layers? Ectoderm, endoderm, and the mesoderm. Again, this is the epiblast, this is the hypoblast. Some cells migrate to replace the hypoblast and form endoderm. Another cells, the red ones, migrate between the epiblast and endoderm to form mesoderm, and the remaining cells form ectoderm. Intraembryonic mesoderm. The intraembryonic mesoderm, we'll talk about its origin, distribution, and the divisions. As I said before, it derives from the epiblast from two main sites. Primitive streak is the main source, and the primitive node. It is distributed between the ectoderm and the endoderm. It is divided into three parts by a groove, by this groove, three parts. Paraxial mesoderm, intermediate mesoderm, this one, and the lateral plate mesoderm. Again, this is the intraembryonic mesoderm. This is the ectoderm, endoderm, and the mesoderm. Ectoderm, endoderm, and the mesoderm. It is divided into three parts. Paraxial mesoderm, on each side of the notochord, intermediate mesoderm, and the lateral plate mesoderm. Then allantois. Allantois is diverticulum arising from the caudal part of the yuxac. This is the yuxac. It extends into the connecting stalk. Okay? It extends into the connecting stalk, the future umbilical cord, and it forms the apex of the urinary bladder. Summary of the changes in the third week, or formation of the gastrula or gastrulation, the bilaminar plate becomes trilaminar. This is number one, precordal plate. This is number two, primitive streak. This is number three, primitive node. This is number four, notochord. Three germ layers, ectoderm, endoderm, mesoderm, and the formation of allantois.
Say goodbye. Say goodbye.